everyone. Welcome to The Big Picture. I'm Judge Penny Wolfgang, in for Phil Arnow. At this time of year, we hear a lot about zombies. I make the same stupid joke every time we talk about this subject, but it just comes to your mind, zombies. However, our topic on the program today, it's not Halloween. Instead, it's about the Zombie Initiative. Here to tell us what that means and to update us on how COVID has changed how we can get a license or other services at the Auto Bureau is Erie County Clerk Michael, also known as Mickey Kearns, one of our favorite people. Hi, Mickey.
Hi. How are you doing?
Mickey joins us through Zoom technology from his office in downtown Buffalo. Welcome, County Clerk Kearns. And we're going to begin by telling everybody the real secret. What do we mean when we say a zombie home? Is it scary? Is it frightening?
It can be scary and frightening. I always say, you know, when you think about building wealth in this country, your largest investment is your home. And when someone is purchasing a neighborhood, they look at or purchasing a home, they look at many things, including the school system if they have young children. But I always say, not only buy the house, you buy the neighborhood. And when you look at a zombie, what that is, and especially now when we're facing unprecedented times with COVID-19, if someone does not pay their mortgage and that mortgage goes into foreclosure, the list pending is filed here at the Erie County Clerk's office, that may create a zombie property for the neighborhood. And I always say people really don't pay attention to things until it impacts them. And we've had zombie properties in some of the most affluent areas of Erie County, and some not so affluent, urban, suburban, first ring suburbs. It does not impact every neighborhood, but until you have a zombie next door to you, then you'll find out that it's a very important issue.
They didn't name zombie after Halloween or zombie. It really stands for something, I found out, right? Zombie?
Yeah, you know what? You know, zombies are scary. And, you know, when you think about it, at the Erie County Clerk's office, we have a zombie task force. And we're trying our best to have solutions to these problems. We're working with the service providers. We're working with the banks. And a zombie property, going back to my assemblyman days, I was an urban legislator. I represented South Buffalo on the Buffalo Common Council. A lot of vacant and abandoned properties. At one point in time, the city of Buffalo had the second most vacant properties than any other municipality in the country, its size, only Biloxi, Mississippi, after the terrible hurricane. So you could see a lot of experience. That's turned the corner in Buffalo. We're seeing unprecedented investment. Now, the first ring suburbs, places like West Seneca, when I became the assembly member working with the former supervisor, Sheo Megan, they had over 100 zombie properties. They're down to a handful now. So we've been working closely with the elected officials, with the Western New York Law Center to do our best.
Oh, you mentioned the Western New York Law Center. What does that have to do with, you know, your initiative on the zombie property? What do they do? How do you work with them?
Sure. Going back once again to my assemblyman days, they lobbied in Albany. We worked together when I helped pass the Foreclosure Relief Act of 2016. They were instrumental in helping us draft that legislation and working with us. And basically, they're a not-for-profit that's funded by state government, and they help people who are going through these difficult times. So if someone is watching and they're facing a foreclosure, there's no income limits. You can live in Clarence, you can live in the city of Buffalo. They're there to give free legal advice. And I decided when I became the Erie County Clerk that with my experience, we could be proactive working with the West New York Law Center and working with the Erie County legislator. We were able to get a contract with them where they are working 100% on zombie properties in Erie County for us in those legislative districts and making sure that we could get these properties back on the tax rolls.
Now, you note that the 2008 economic downturn accelerated the rise of foreclosures then, leading to these abandoned homes, and now we're in another economic downturn here with COVID. So are we going to see more of these homes as people struggle?
It's amazing, because yesterday the county executive along with the mayor of the city of Buffalo and myself, announced a $10 million initiative to help people who are falling behind on their rent so they're not evicted. The eviction and foreclosure moratorium will be up in January of 2021. And what's concerning is going back, I keep on saying in my assembly member days, back in 2008, we had the Great Recession. When I became an assembly member in 2012, we still felt the ripples of that Great Recession. We passed the foreclosure relief back in 2016. What concerns me is at that time, unemployment was at approximately 8%. And Western New York never felt the housing bubble, meaning our properties never elevated to record sales. Today, we have had record sales. We've had multiple offers on properties. It's a hot housing market. People are overpaying. And what concerns me, Judge, is that people who have overpaid, there's not a lot of equity within their home. So I do fear that because unemployment rate, I know the numbers were just announced, we were at one point in time post-COVID at about 18%. We're down to about 10%, which is excellent, believe it or not, in a pandemic. But we're hopeful that it goes down. So hopefully putting off people having to leave their home, because what do they say in a pandemic, COVID-19? Go to your home. If you don't have a home to go to, where do you go?
And stay home. And stay home.
So we've been, it was a great announcement yesterday. It was a partnership with the county executive, with the mayor of City of Buffalo, with 211, with the Erie County Clerk's Office. And, you know, this is what we have to do in government. We have to work together as a team during crisis times to help people, put people before politics. And that's what good government's all about.
Now, what's the relationship with the government, the banks, and how do you hold either one of them accountable?
So one of the things I wanted to do is when I became the clerk, we formed something called the Erie County Clerk's Foreclosure Task Force. And what we do is on a quarterly basis, we bring together elected officials, the representatives of the communities, the building inspectors. They're the ones going out, they're getting the complaints from the neighbors. Hey, there's a property, we think it's abandoned, the grass hasn't been cut. And also the service providers. And we told the banks, we're holding the banks accountable. We don't have too many problems with our local banks. Our local banks are very responsive to us, but we now have some national banks, banks like Wells Fargo. Prior to COVID-19, they would send a representative in from New York. So we're doing our best to get solutions to the problems, bringing people to the table so we could be proactive on this issue.
We had so many foreclosures in the courts. We couldn't handle them. A couple of years ago, we had special parts just for foreclosures, and it was really terrible. And I just hope we don't see anything like that again. Now, I know you have a website for people who have questions about properties in their neighborhood. It's ErieCountyClerkZombies.com, my favorite. Right. So what will people find on the site if they go there, Mickey?
Sure. Number one is there are tools in place from the Foreclosure Relief Act. If you know about a zombie property, you can email us. You can even email me at my office, erie.gov/clerk. We need to file a complaint with the Department of Financial Services. That's one tool that we use. They reach out to the service providers to say, hey, you know, what's going on with this property? And, other information, if you are facing a foreclosure, a possible job loss because of COVID-19, the one advice I could say is there's contact information for the Western New York Law Center so you could stay in your home. We want people to stay in their home until this crisis is over so we can help people through this. And listen, we know that in some instances, if two people are getting divorced or if there's a health crisis and someone says, hey, we're moving on, or there's an estate issue, we're in conversations right now with the county executive about how we can help post COVID-19, help people with that and get the proper funding. So I put it in my budget. I'm hopeful that the legislature will be responsive to our request because, as you know, Judge, this is an issue that is not going away for many, many years.
And it's amazing that it came up again, you know, after we thought we had it handled all those years ago, and now it came up again. So like you said, it's not going away. It's something that has to be taken care of, and you guys are doing such a good job having all these working together with the banks and the foreclosure and the government and the law institute. So anyway, when we come back after the break, we are going to get an update about another issue from Erie County Clerk Mickey Kearns. We're going to talk about how you can handle your automotive business. So please stay with us.